Hello everybody, here Renee again with a new video. I think I have to sit a little bit lower, if not you cannot see me. Like this, I think. I'm gonna sit here. Okay, like always, I never prepare my videos very well, but who cares anyway. I hope everybody's having a great summer. I'm working most of the time. In the weekends I go with my family, with my wife and my child. We are going to the beach, that's quite nice. Saturday afternoon and Sunday we have quite good times like that. And also in the meantime I get some mail, some records came in. This morning I went to the post office and I picked up one packet that will show you soon. Plus I got some other cool stuff. This one is a split CD with four bands, Four Doors to Death, that a guy showed on YouTube, a YouTuber, and I forgot his name and forgot to check it out. But anyway, thanks to this guy, I discovered this nice and cool release with four bands that I really enjoy. There's only one band from this CD that I knew, and that band is Trench Rot. I have their CD and their demo on tape, and the first full-length album I have it on CD. And the cool thing about this CD is that there is four inlays, one for each band, but there's only one CD. But each band has the original cover, I mean nice cover. This is Sabatori, recorded in 2015. There's a cover song on here by the band Mortuary Drape. It's an Italian occult black metal band, very cool band. I own some stuff by them. But I never knew about this band, Sabatori. But it's an old school death metal. Okay, here we have Trench Rot. Of course, I just talked about them a little bit. This is death thrash metal. I mean, definitely they're influenced by the early stuff by the band Death, like Screamy Bloody Gory or Leprosy, especially. You can really hear those influences. Here we have another inlay by the band Cemetery Filth. Again, a death metal band. See? Like a satanic death metal band. Influenced by bands like Morbid Angel. Definitely they are. And here we have Ectovoid. See, also, if I'm not mistaken, this is more black metal. I didn't really play this very much yet, only a couple of times, the songs, but they're very good songs. And if you're into old death, old primitive black metal, I mean, you really have to check out this split CD. I definitely enjoyed it. CD's here. Cool. And this comes also with this slipcase to protect the CD a little bit. Very cool release. Four Doors to Death. Check this out. This came out on Dark Descent Records. They're doing a good job, these Dark Descent Records. Okay, now something totally different. I bought this Fierce Heart. This is a promo copy. You see there, Fierce Heart. And here we have Rex Carroll is playing the guitar on this album. And of course later he formed White Cross. I like White Cross a lot more than this, the music on this album. But it's not bad. It's like hard and heavy, melodic hard rock, with some melodic heavy metal too. Some cool guitar riffs by Rex Carroll. He does all the guitars on this record. And this was released back in 85. I don't think it did so well, because it's not, not a well-known album. You know, I'm also, people that follow my channel, you know I'm very much into soundtracks. And this is a soundtrack I just picked up, Gotcha, of the good movie. You know, an American guy meets a spy, a female spy in Paris. Later he goes to East Europe, I mean to East Berlin. And there, of course, he has to escape from East Berlin to West Berlin. But of course, you had still the wall there in the middle. And it's a quite good movie. I remember seeing this movie. And here we have Joan Jett and Black Hearts. And the Black Hearts are on here. And two songs by Jufria. You know, and that's very cool, because these songs were not on the two albums by Jufria that they record in the 80s. These are unreleased tracks, you know, like special for this soundtrack. Never Too Late and Say It Ain't True. Plus, Greg Jufria also produced a song by the band Camouflage. What's your name? That's cool. Let me see if I can tell you some more things about it. No, not really. Just a good soundtrack. If you want to see me talking about more soundtracks, check my soundtrack videos on my channel. If you put soundtracks, then all the soundtrack videos come out, where you can see soundtracks of hard rock and heavy metal related soundtracks. Good. Today I picked up a packet from EMP Records. EMP from Germany. They sell worldwide. And this is not for me, this is for my wife. Because, like me, she is a Grave Digger fan. But the last three or four records, you know, she didn't really like them so much. And I didn't thought they were special either. I think since The Last Supper, they were not so interesting. But the other day, I listened to the vinyl copy from Return of the Ripper. I played it home, and she said, "Oh, this is really great. I would love to have it on CD to play it in the car." That's why I bought it for her. Return of the Ripper, the last studio album to date, from 2014, by Grave Digger, of course. And this, you can really see, they're back in form. It's an amazing, amazing album. And soon I'm going to see them live again, in 2 weeks' time. And I also ordered a vinyl for me. Sometimes EMP Records have special deals, like you don't have to pay for sending costs. And I bought this band from Sweden, and there it's a female band. It's Thunder Mother, formed by five girls. See? And they are definitely influenced by bands like Girl School or Motorhead too. So they got some Motorhead, Kiss, a lot of 70s hard rock, you know. AC/DC, the big AC/DC fans, and this is on red wine. I'm going to open it right now. I don't want to break the plastic, but I don't have a lot of sleeves. I have to make some more. I can make them myself. Record sleeves. But you can also see a video on my channel where I make record sleeves. You don't have to buy them for an expensive price. You can make them yourself if you want to. And then you have more money for vinyl and for CDs to buy. I think I have to take it just off. I know some, like Aaron, does this. And then it opens. Let me see. No one. I hope so you're having a great summer. Okay, yes, it works. It's a little bent now, the side. But anyway. I'm checking if somebody's coming in. No. I think this is on red vinyl. Yes, it is. Red vinyl. Beautiful custom labels. And the guy that showed these records is George. George Weldhart or something like that. He showed this album before. And then I checked it out. And I really... It's fucking... It's breaking already. Anyway. Here you can see the photos. And here... The song lyrics. I'm really happy with this record. Definitely I am. So I'm going to start playing it after this video. And that will be right now, because I'm going to cut this off. Stay metal, everybody. Thanks for watching.